Lives. Right. I don't want to let the life tell me. up there telling you that?
I don't know. I found her hanging in her closet.
Not cancer, why did you tie it to?
I don't know if there was cancer or not.
You didn't untie them. You weren't tied when you went there. Those are the small things when people freak out. They're trying to make things happen.
I'm not.
Cover up.
Yeah, I freaked out because I found my own daughter hanging. Am I supposed to be ecstatic about that?
You're probably not going to go back and untie all the knots and pull everything down and clean up the room before you're dealing with your deceased daughter. That's not logical.
I didn't clean anything in that house.
You didn't take her. You just said she's supposed to be hanging there.
Yes.
Put her off the ground, you said yesterday. Put her off the ground.
I removed her from the closet.
The pajamas that weren't even tied around the rock. How is that possible?
I don't know what she was hanging from.
It's not true. Kelsie, we went in and measured from the ground to that dowel she was reportedly hanging from. You know, those pants are, she's a tall girl. I mean, those pants are 2-3 feet long. If she was actually hanging like you said, she would have been touching the ground. No freaking way.
I have a visitation that I have to get ready for. Can I leave? I am talking to you. I am telling you everything.
You're talking about everything but the incident where she dies.
Because I was asleep.
It's not possible. We talked about that, Kelsie. You can say that all you want that you're asleep. I wish you were asleep. You wish that you were asleep.
I was asleep.
So you woke up, you got into an argument,
no,
and she died.
I didn't.
That's what happened.
No, it's not.
When you wake up to go to the bathroom and say, you know what? Today's the day. She's sleeping in that bed of hers, and I'm going to go choke her out on a strangler.
Are you listening to anything that you're saying?
That's the only thing that I can think of. If it's not out of frustration, it's not out of anger, then it's got to be out of hate.
No, I didn't take my daughter.
Put her in the closet. You tried to make it look like she was in the closet. The evidence shows that.
I found her.
To the
closet. They put her in the closet. I removed her from the closet.
Not hanging in that box. It's not possible. Science wouldn't allow that. She was not hanging in that box.
I found her in the closet.
You did not find her hanging in the closet.
Whatever. I found her in that closet.
But she didn't find her hanging in the closet or hanging in the closet.
She was in there, hanging. It looked like she was hanging. Okay, I removed her from the closet and put her on her bed.
I think we're getting somewhere now. You're acknowledging that you're doubting the fact that she was...
Because you guys are in my fucking head.
As many times as you have told us and stuck to your story that you did not kill your daughter...
I didn't kill my daughter. No, I didn't.
You're not going to slip up on the fact of whether I believe she was hanging in there. So your daughter wasn't hanging in the closet.
I found her hanging in the closet. Why are you guys trying to put words in my mouth?
You're the one who just said it, not me.
She's alive when I went to sleep. She was not when I woke up. The only reason why you guys are fucking blaming me or accusing me is because I was the only one there.
That's not why.
So what, if my husband was there, would he be in the same fucking case scenario?
Absolutely. 100%. We had the same conversation with him after. Circle these things, like I said. You're the only one that believed in you.
killed your daughter?
But I didn't kill my daughter.
Okay, we thought it was hiding in the closet.
right.
You see, it's never looked like we got to be told himself that. Because you know she wasn't any
of it. I didn't kill my daughter. You guys can continue to sit here and fucking get me to say that I did, but I didn't do it.
I don't think I just wanted to pass the fact that your daughter wasn't in the closet. I want to keep getting away from the fact that your daughter wasn't in the closet when I tell you your daughter wasn't in the closet. Because she wasn't.
I found her in her closet.
Sure. Yeah. And maybe she was in the closet at some point during that day. I'm not going to talk about how she got in that closet, but what I am going to say is you did not find your daughter.
She looked like she was in the closet. When I walked in there, it looked like she was hanging in her closet.
I'm afraid to even ask to describe how she was hanging at this point, because we're probably going to get a different story in the first place, because if I asked somebody to describe how they found her daughter, and they said my daughter was hanging, and she had a pair of pants around her neck.
It looked like a pair of pants.
That she had something, my daughter had something around her neck that was supporting all of her weight, and she was suspended from that item, regardless of what I'm saying was a pair of pants. And now you're saying, it looks like she was hanging. There's no mistaking that.
There's nothing that I know of was on her floor.
What are you trying to say?
Even to be able to detect if she was suspended or what?
Well, we asked her, you specifically said that, which again is a lie. There's no way your daughter was suspended. But on measuring tape, no, she wasn't. Reducing it to that simple addition, had her hands in, had her daughter's height, she wasn't hanging. Your lies are starting to unravel.
I didn't kill my daughter.
Okay, that's fine. If you want to keep saying that, that's fine.
I'm going to continue to say it.
And that's fine, Kelsie. If that's what you want to do. But again, your lies are starting to unravel, and you know that.
I'm not lying.
You did not find your daughter in her closet.
I found her in her closet.
But not me.
That's what she looked like.
How does someone kind of sort of look like their hand? Any other way than the way you said,
She would have had to have something wrapped all the way around her neck. Therefore, you would have had to have untied something to get rid of
it. And I didn't have to untie anything.
Okay. So now we're back to the impossible of what was keeping her head in there.
I don't know.
Because it's not the way you said. That's why. Kelsie, we're trying to give you this opportunity. We're going through every piece of evidence with you. We're not twisting and turning things. We're saying, here's what we see. Tell us how it's different, and you can't.
I was asleep. That's it.
Maybe at some point you were asleep, sure. But you also woke up at some point.
No, I didn't.
You never woke up?
I went to sleep and woke up when my alarm went off, and that is when I found her. Going on through Chloe's head, or whatever goes on through her head.
our situation, because there really is no other explanation. You can't even think of one. As you sit here now and you stop thought about it for a whole week, when you're thinking that you're kidding rather than accident, and you don't know how that would happen.
I don't, but I didn't do it.
Because it can't be an accident. That's why you can't.
I'm not going to say that I killed my daughter when I didn't kill her.
I think you just don't want to say you killed your daughter.
No, I didn't.
It's a hard thing to say. I get it. Even if everything I'm saying is true, sitting there as you, that would be a hard thing to say.
Why would I want to spend the rest of my life in jail saying that I did something that I didn't do?
I don't want to.
Honestly.
I don't want you to do something they didn't. That's not what I do. I don't want you to make something up.
I'm not.
I'm just saying, sitting there, if we all in this room agree that you did this, I still think it would be hard for you to admit that. I'm agreeing with you.
I'm not going to admit something I didn't do. That's why I'm not admitting to anything, because I didn't do it.
The question you just asked was like, why would anybody commit a crime and then know they're going to go to jail for the rest of their life? People don't think about the repercussions, especially when something snaps.
I didn't snap.
The repercussions are an afterthought.
Tell a story that sheds the best light on us as a mom and dad.
I didn't know
simply not possible. And I told another lie to help correct that other lie. And now it's not possible. And I keep trying to tread water, but eventually you just get tired. And we're all going to accept that the truth comes out. It's hard to keep up the lie. It's hard to keep the straight face. It's hard to keep denying things. When I'm on the inside, they're screaming on the inside. I am so sorry that I did this. I did not want to do this. But you're scared of what happens next. You're scared of what people are going to think.
I don't care what people think. Because I didn't do it.
homicide. You're the person there.
That's the proof. Not the proof is if somebody dies in a car crash and has a gunshot wound, they didn't die in a car crash. You get that, right?
Yes, I do.
Because you say she was hanging in a closet doesn't mean that's what happened to her.
I didn't kill her.
That doesn't, you're not even making sense, though. So are you saying you didn't kill her and you just put her in a closet?
No! I found her in the closet.
So if you didn't kill her, you did?
I don't know.
So she's the only one at
home? I'm not the only one that has access to my fucking house.
So now somebody else came in while you were sleeping and drove boat and then left.
I'm not saying that.
While you were sleeping. You're not saying that because it's not possible. It's not what happened. No one else is going to believe that. No one had to do that. I mean, it's your daughter. No random person came in. You confirmed that Aaron wasn't there. You confirmed Aaron wasn't there. Stop and think about it. You really can't be that upset with it. Sure, you don't like these questions, but you know these are legitimate questions. You know we're not coming at you with bullshit. We're coming at you with facts. Like I said, those marks around your daughter's neck tells and paints a picture that is very, absolutely 110% contradictory to what you said.
I didn't put any marks around my nose.
This is what happens every time I say something. You put something and you turn it, and you bring something from over here and you try to put it in front of my face. You can't stay on point when confronted with a lie. I'm telling you that the marks around your daughter's neck are not consistent with any of the item or the item you said was around her neck. There's no mix-up in what you're saying. You told us those pajamas were there. You're just trying to twist it now because you know that we're confronting you with the fact that that is not plausible.
I didn't kill my daughter.
Again, this is what we always come back to.
Yeah, and I'm going to continue to say it because I didn't kill my daughter.
You're trying to repeat what I just said.
Yeah, I'm listening to every single fucking word that's coming out of your mouth.
So what's
but I didn't kill
so
her.
What's the explanation for the fact that you're telling us specifically what was around your daughter's neck?
Because that is where I found her. I found her hanging in her closet.
With those pants is what you told us.
They look like pants.
And maybe that does not match whatsoever. And again, the only time you're wavering on those pants is this third time when we confronted you with that's not what it is. So again, it makes sense that when you tell us she's hanging, you tell these pants, we tell you not those pants. And now we're up in the air. Again, the lies unraveled when they're put together quickly. It just doesn't hold up. You know that. Again, no matter how pissed at us you want to be, if you keep saying, I didn't do this, and then we're just lying out our ass, which you know we're not. Deep down, whether you want to believe it in your head or not, you subconsciously know that we know what happened. We just ended up not led up to it. Because that's what's going to make a difference going down the road with how this is viewed. Taking responsibility for the actions that took place and telling us how things happened.
Nothing even happened between me and her that day. Absolutely nothing.
And she was not saying her room. She just knows what happened.
No, she was in her room.
That's what? She's not saying her room.
No, she was in her room.
That's really you can say to yourself, that's not blue.
No, not normally.
Have you said anything? She was afraid to come out of her room. Or she was already dead for you.
No. When I grabbed Phoenix out of her room and I turned around and told her that if she would stay in bed that I was going to be harassed, she was awake.
Of course, again, if someone's deceased, why would things
I don't know. I don't know. I have found that on her mouth. So I sat her up and I used my finger to try to get out what was ever in her throat or what I thought, you know, was in her throat. And I laid her back down and I called 911. And I watched them suction out her throat at the hospital while we were doing CPR on her.
How does a dead person have that much stuff when, again, by all means, their body is living? There's nothing going on in their body.
I don't know. I've never seen a dead body until now. I don't watch the fucking the shows that they have on TV about all this.
Wouldn't it make sense if maybe she did come out of her room? I don't know. I don't know there before you did that. Maybe threw on the bed or held her down on the bed. I wanted to stay in bed.
Let's talk about it. Let's talk further now. I think we need some help.
Exhibit A, I'm ready for this. What happened before you shut that door? What happened in there? She's, I know she's alive. I know she's bounced out of the walls. I know that when I had two kids, and I had only been having two girls, they were pronounced everybody's sick. So,
yeah.
And I only heard you were standing around for a couple of hours. That's not much to ask, but after. Take us through it.
Thank you. small amount, and then you're going to, you'd like to play the remainder of the video, and that's about an hour 20 minutes?
21, yes.
Hour 21 minutes, okay. We could maybe do that on one stretch if your direct is not going to be very long.
Perfect, Your Honor.
Yeah, that will work?
Sure.
Okay, so that'll be our alternative plan.
Yes, Your Honor.